Hello, and welcome to this tutorial for BioXTAS RAW. In this tutorial, you will learn how to load, average, subtract, and save individual scattering profiles. So when you first open RAW, you'll see a window like what's being shown here. We have the plot panel on the right, in the center. This has different types of plots for different types of data. This is where data that you load into RAW will be displayed. On the left, we have the control panel. You use the Files tab to interact with files on disk to do things like load data into the program. And then the Profiles, IFTs, and Series tab lets you work with data that you've already loaded into the program. This is where you'll do things like average and subtract your data sets, as well as various types of analysis. Now, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to load up some data. This uses the tutorial data. You can download that from the RAW website. I've already done so, and it's on my desktop. In order to change to a new folder in this, you can see the folder you're currently in is displayed in this top bar here. We click on this folder icon to the right, and that allows us to pull up a window that changes where we are. I'm going to use the standards data in the tutorial data. So I open that folder, and then I click open. And you can see all the files in that folder are now displayed in the files control panel here. You can scroll down and see all the different data. Now, I do want to mention you can also navigate from within this list of files. If you double-click on these two dots, or this up arrow, it'll go up a level. So you can see I'm now up to the main tutorial data. And then if you double-click on a folder, it'll take you back down into that folder. So in this folder, what you see is we have a bunch of TIFF files. These are two-dimensional scattering images collected by your X-ray detector. And usually in SAXS data, we work with one-dimensional scattering profiles, intensity versus Q. In order to load in these TIFF files, we have to load in a configuration file. This configuration file tells RAW various information that needs to know to go from these 2D files to a 1D file. Things like where the beam center is, the sample to detector distance, and the X-ray energy. So if I go down to the bottom of the files control panel, there's this tab. I'm going to click on it, and I'm going to select CFG files. This is the configuration file. That now only displays the configuration files that are in the folder. It filters out what you can see in the file list. You can see there's two different configuration files. I'm going to use the SAXS configuration, because we're interested in the SAXS data right now. You can just double-click that to load the file into RAW. Alternatively, if you go to the Files menu, you can use the Load Settings. It does the same thing. Note that for each experiment you do, you'll have a different configuration file. So you shouldn't use this configuration file for a different experiment. You should make sure that if you have image files you need to process in RAW, you either make or obtain the correct configuration file for that particular experiment to load them in. So now that we've loaded in a configuration file, we're ready to load in these images. So I'm going to select the TIFFs filter here. This just shows me the image files. And I'm going to load in this GI2 data set. So this is glucose isomerase. This is 10 different images of the same sample. They're each 1 second image. The reason we take multiple images instead of one long image is so we can look for radiation damage to the sample. There are multiple ways we can load these files into RAW. The simplest is just to double-click on a file. If I do that, RAW takes the image, it automatically reduces it to a one-dimensional scattering profile, and it plots that scattering profile here on the main plot. Alternatively, I can select it, and I can click Plot. And you see that there. It's now plotted this one, so I have two profiles loaded in, the orange and the blue. The easiest way, though, if we have 10 different files, it's a little tedious to click on each one. So we can select multiple files at a time. If I click on two, then I can then Control-click, or if you're on a Mac, Command-click, to select three and four, and then I can click Plot to plot all of those at once. So now we have 0 to 4 plotted up here on the main plot. Alternatively, if I click on five and then Shift-click on nine, it selects everything in between, as well as those two. I can then click on Plot, and that plots all of those. If I go to the Profiles tab, this is where we can look at what data we have loaded in. So here, each name corresponds to a single scattering profile. Each of these is on the main plot. And you can see we've got 0 through 9 here, so we've got all 10 files that correspond to the 10 images that we collected. Now, when we collect SAXS data, we measure the sample in solution. Turns out the protein scattering is not very much more than the solution scattering by itself, so we also measure the buffer. So I need to load in the buffer file, and then I need to subtract that from the protein scattering file. So here the buffer file is this gibuff2. I'm going to select that, I'm going to plot it. You can see that plots here on the main plot, and it shows up in the profiles. The next thing I want to do is I want to average these. We took a bunch of images to look for radiation damage. If there were radiation damage, you'd see some changes. We don't. So I'm going to select them here just by clicking on the name and the profiles tab. You can see the one I click on goes blue. I'm going to shift click to select all of these GIs, but none of the buffers. Then I'm going to click average. That creates a single averaged scattering profile for all of the glucose isomerase. And if you scroll down in the profiles list, what you'll see is we've created a new profile, this A underscore GI2, which is the average profile. Now, it's hard to see it on the main plot because there's all these noisy individual profiles there, so I can hide those on the main plot. The way you do that is with this show hide button here, this I, if I click on it, it hides the individual profile that I've clicked on it for. It's a little bit tedious to click on it for every single profile, so for the ones that I have selected, if I click on the hide button here, it hides everything I have selected, and now you can see just the individual averaged profile. I'm going to repeat this for the buffer file. So I'm going to just select all of the buffer files. I'm going to click average. You'll see that it creates a new average down here. And then I'm going to hide all the individual files. Alternatively, if you have a lot of things loaded onto the plot and you're not sure what's what, the color for each one is shown in this bar here. So you can see that this average GI one is blue. This average buffer is orange. And if you click on this locate line, this target, it'll bold the line on the plot so that you can see which one it is. And then you click it again to unbold it. Now that we've created an average protein and an average buffer file, we want to subtract the buffer scattering. So to do this, we have to tell raw which one is the buffer. You click the star button here, and now raw knows that this gibuff2, this agibuff2 file, is the buffer file. And then anything that we have selected, so if I click on this GI file, you see it goes blue, it's now selected. Anything I have selected when I click subtract, it's going to subtract that buffer from the selected file. So if I click subtract now, it subtracts the buffer from this AGI2 and creates a subtracted scattering profile S_A_GI2, which you can see here on the bottom plot, the subtracted plot. You'll notice there's not really a lot of signal out here at high Q, that's fine, but we've got a good data set down here at low Q. At this point now, I'm actually done with all of these individual scattering profiles for the buffer and for the sample. I don't need them in raw anymore, so I'm going to remove them. If I select all of them just by shift-clicking, and then I click remove, that removes them from the program. It doesn't do anything to the data on disk, that's all safe. It just clears them from the program to both reduce the memory usage and to make it a lot easier to see what you have loaded in. So next we're going to load in another data set. If we go back to the files tab and scroll down, we'll see that there are these lyse2 files and the lysebuff2 files. This is lysozyme, and I'm going to show you another way to load files into raw. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a file browser. This is Finder on Mac or Windows Explorer or whatever it happens to be on your computer. I've already browsed to the tutorial data standards data folder. So in RAW, you can load in data by dragging and dropping. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select all of the lysozyme data, just the TIFF files, not the log files, and I'm going to just drag and drop that onto the top plot. And you can see it loads it all in, it plots it, and if we go to the profiles, we'll see that we've loaded in all of those lysozyme profiles. I'm going to do the same thing for the buffer files. Select them all, and just drag them and drop them onto the top plot. And we've got all the profiles loaded in for both the sample and the buffer. Now I'm going to do the same thing that we did for glucose isomerase. I'm going to select the sample just by shift-clicking. I'm going to average, and then I'm going to hide it. I'm going to select the buffer, and I'm going to average this. I should note that you can access the average and the subtraction in various functions by right-clicking on a file and then selecting the appropriate option in the right-click menu. So here I'm going to average, and you can hide it and see again that we have the lysozyme and the lyse buffer file. Now what we want to do is subtract it, create the subtracted lyse buffer, subtracted lysozyme. So I'm going to star the buffer, select the sample, and click subtract. That creates this orange subtracted profile here. You can see it on the bottom of the list. Once again, we're done with all the individual scattering profiles, so I'm going to select these and click remove to clear them from the program. That leaves me with just the averaged and subtracted files. Now, we're actually done with all the averaged files as well. We've created the subtracted files. That's what we're going to work with. It's good to save these in case you want to come back to them, recreate the subtracted data, start from scratch. So what I'm going to do is select them. Here I'm going to Control-click to select all four at once. And then I'm going to click Save. Here, if you're saving multiple files, you just select the save directory and you click open, and it will save them all as .dat files. .dat files are standard scattering profile format for SAXS data. When I save it, you should notice two things happen. So this star that you can still see for the subtracted profiles goes away. When you see a star on a profile, it indicates it has unsubtracted changes. The other thing is it automatically added in the file extension. When you save files in a group like this, it gives them the name that's shown in RAW. So if I go to the Files tab, and I want to look for the different DATs, click down here, select DAT, you can see that I have this AGI2, AGIBuff2, etc., all as DAT files. If you were to save a file individually, say right-click and save selected file, or just select it and click Save, that gives you the option to change the name if you want. I've already saved this file, so I'm not going to bother saving it again. So now that we have everything saved, we're done with these average profiles, so I'm going to select them and remove them, leaving just the subtracted profiles in RAW. The final thing that I want to mention in this tutorial is that you can manipulate the plots to show different types of axes. If you right-click on the plot, you can see some options. There's the axes menu. Change that to log-log, for example, to get a log-log plot. Go back to log-lin. So this allows you to visualize your data sets in different ways. With that, that's the end of the tutorial. You now should know how to load individual scattering profiles into RAW, either through the Files tab or by dragging and dropping. You know how to average and subtract files, and you know how to save files and remove them from RAW.